Listen and remember what we're talking about is propaganda. We're not talking about the truth. We're talking about propaganda. Watch this.
Good evening to you. Welcome to the news feed of rap news transmitting through on Juice Media. As you should be aware, the UN and its members hold a meeting in Copenhagen 7th December. A new committee, which a few have written is the most important diplomatic gathering in human history. The first was Earth Summit in 92. 17 years on, climate change still divides views. Is the crisis true? Is it definitely our fault? Former Vice President Al Gore.
Howdy.
Mr. Gore, there's a skeptic core vocally expressing the contention that your text is flawed.
Listen, y'all, we can no longer sit on the wall. Our roller coaster is headed for a fall. The mission is still to reduce emissions that kill. But do we have the political will? We see on this steel. No need to be clever to see that CO2 and world heat go together. It goes way off the tip. I need a crane to see the top. But if we don't stop a bit, we're headed straight for apocalypse. It's obvious.
Okay, it's time to debate perspectives. This is Lord Monckton, the climate change skeptic. Lord Monckton,
how do you do?
Climate change. What are your views?
My views? Well, I can explain. My views can be summed up in a word. Anthropogenic, utterly dumb and absurd. It's a plot to tax hard-working lords like me and you. Ego lingua latina non tenios et magister meus carebo me paide carwit. We must fight it. It's our rights they're trying to target. Bloody pink or green martyrs, they have all been hypnotized by that con artist Al Gore. His video's fake, Beelzebub seed. I said schools should ban it and a British judge agreed. Stop televising him, the temperature is not rising. I'm not lying and unlike Gore, I'm not proselytizing.
Well, I'm not proselytizing, I'm providing the inconvenient truth on DVD for $25.99. And if we keep piling CO2 at a maximum rate, disaster awaits. We need cap and trade.
Cap and trade? That's just a masquerade. A large charade, a smokescreen for the master race. You can't escape. The people are rising. They'll stop Copenhagen and the treaty they're signing.
A treaty? What treaty?
Why, the one that blends all Obama's friends into a one world government. If he signs, freedom dies, no more cheap flights.
But he'll be in Norway, getting his war as peace prize.
Can we see the treaty you mentioned?
Oh yeah, it's right here. Hey, what's that over there? Oh, you don't need to see it. I remember the words. They want to tax our wealth for the developing world.
And you don't feel obliged to provide some assistance when we still generate 90% of emissions?
We're not in debt for emissions. We made the empire. The natives should pay us for elevating them higher. The queen kept the money. The poor get the boot. Now they're running little schemes trying to play us for our loot. Speaking of proof, have you seen Inconvenient Truth? I found 35 fallacies that need to be removed.
35? Maybe that's why the Academy liked it. Look, it ain't perfect, but it's backed by science.
Backed by science? Trying to attract high finance. Keep average guys blind and taxed by tyrants.
Sure, Viscount, you care for average guys' crisis. Weeping in your castle as the black tide rises.
And prices? The IPCC are Marxist. Trapeze artists bleeding the free market. We're the target. They'll keep us herded in corners. One currency, one government, a new world order.
It's better than the corner. Let this fact just sink in. World, unite. Or face the sick mass extinction.
A feedback cycle. Death of the Gulf Stream. We need clean coal or it's the end of the Holocene.
That's just postulated. We've got to collect it. Secretly these people want the earth depopulated. A communist dictatorship. A way station. Good Christians killed by UN troops and AIDS patients.
You strain my patience. You're scaremongering.
It's freedom they're plundering. And you're the scaremonger king.
I got my Nobel Prize. I was nearly the president.
And I share that prize for revealing this evidence.
You got a pin melted down from a physics experiment.
You're a pin melted down from a physics experiment.
Lord Monckton, let me hear from you. Have any of your articles been peer-reviewed?
Well, no, but the SPPI has published a few.
The Science and Public Policy Institute. Their chief policy advisor happens to be who?
Well, me,
you. So you publish you. I think we've heard enough from you. People, please, research the truth. Nowadays it isn't tough to do.
Mr. Gore, Robert, we need global governance. A new world order to replace local governments.
And I suppose who better to comprise it than the very same people who altered the climate?
For sure, who else?
Perhaps the same ones who took care of the planet. And
until we came along.
Okay, Pocahontas, what kinkiness you into? Want us wearing loincloths, living in igloos? People need to just carry on. We have schemes to offset emissions by planting trees.
Money for new trees? Why not use it to assist local tribes to preserve forests that still exist?
Would that make me more rich? No, tax is the way. And if that just fails, I'll become Captain Tree!
That's about it for this episode, but I'd like to end the show with some thoughts before I let you go. Some commentators are now on their feet, saying climate change is a plot by the power elite. It's tempting to cry victim when the system curbs behavior, but are we the victims or are we the perpetrators? Our wealth was extorted from the turf of our neighbors, never mind genocide and murder of nature. Can we return what we've taken in a dignified praxis, or keep complaining about paying high taxes? And as for the pilgrims to Copenhagen, hoping that token statements and hope can save them, can reparations and carbon trading hold at bay the payment for 2 centuries of global raping? If Arctic ice will be missed within 6 years, can we let these leaders just sit shifting deck chairs? And as we get scared, teetering on the tipping point, at what stage will we consult that missing voice? In April, an indigenous summit met in Anchorage, pledging knowledge to enable us to handle this. We have technology but lack philosophy. How's 60,000 years track record in ecology to give COP15 any kind of relevance? Shouldn't we invite the world's true environmentalists? Well, whatever's decided when Copenhagen arrives, I'm Robert Foster for Juice Media, saying goodnight.
Wow, there's a lot to do. Remember the good old days when we could sit back and just watch TV and it really didn't matter? Not anymore. We hit the money.